The fourth one is PTOR characteristics and load locus. So what you have done last time is step response and disturbance response. So finding step response, the disturbance input made zero and you are applying various inputs and how the nonlinear element is present that is affecting the response of the system, that you are done. And that about disturbance response also, there you are changed the integral control gain. So in this deep part you are doing speed torque characteristics and the load locus. So speed torque characteristics means speed versus torque. So if you are telling about torque, at a particular speed only that torque will be getting, that is the speed torque characteristic. If you are considering a automobile also, there you will get the speed torque characteristic. At this speed, this much torque you will get. So if you are increasing the speed, torque will decrease, and vice versa. So here the motor also, choosing the motor, if you are having particular speed requirement, particular speed, particular torque requirement is there, you have to choose the, according to this graph, you have to choose the motor. So if you want high speed and high torque, the gear system you cannot use. So for this purpose, in your model number 5, you have to change the step input to sinusoidal command of 100%. Then plot this PTOR characteristic and 10% sinusoidal command at 5 hertz frequency and plot the speed or characteristic. So at the speed is equal to 0, speed is, here it is 0, maximum torque you will get, and when torque is 0 you will get maximum speed, and at the speed is equal to 0 you will get maximum torque. This is called stall torque and this is called no load speed. For a motor, then when there is no load, that time only that motor will be working at the maximum speed. So this locus is getting here. So if your load requirement is falling under this graph, you can select this motor. That is all about speed or characteristic. So you have to apply a sinusoidal command. Why sinusoidal command is, if you are applying a step command, you will get one value. Sinusoidal means entire that sinusoidal sine wave changing these values. What is your output speed torque it is getting? That only you are measuring from speed torque characteristic. That is for 100% command amplitude. That is theta m limit 100% and 10% of this value you are checking. So this is the command using for speed torque characteristic. So Vs by kV is what? Omega. And this is actually maximum torque. KT into Vs by RA. So it is plotting this half and this third quadrant minus Vs by kV and this torque in the first and third. And you are plotting speed torque of 1 and speed torque of 2. If you are, this is for my case only. This command is for my case, because I am using this first channel. This first channel as here speed only I am taking. and torque is taking second channel. Second channel I am taking torque, and the first channel I am taking omega only. So this command is valid for me only. If you are interchange those tapping points, this is all elements 2 comma this all elements 1, you have to select. And the grid on for 10 plotting 10% on above this graph. You plot first this one, then you change this command amplitude to 10, then you plot it, then you will get the speed torque characteristics for this motor in the first and the third. Here it is working as a motor, here it is working as a motor. Here it is generating action, second and the fourth. So those two places it is generating only. So speed torque characteristics for a motor is in first and the third only. So that is the D part. And E part is you have to write the comments. So you have to write the comments about this entire document, second lap, and you have to submit this by next week is fine. In next Monday you have to submit.
That exam will not be over by then.
So when you sir, your exam is over by next 10th or 12th only, na?
No, sir. We have our last exam in 30th.
Some of your batchmates might have exam around 8th or 10th. So last date I can change it to 5th. 5th of October. This is fine, no?
Yes, 5th October is fine.
Yeah. You mail it. I am not creating any model assignment. You just mail it. In this control system, ADD only. So if you are putting any other in my personal mail IDs, I won't validate. You have to put it in control system mail ID only. So this is for fourth and fifth part. You have to write your comments. And the comments should be very precise. Don't write a half page, one comment. What it is mean, that one only you write. Sometimes you can write some half page essay for this sinusoidal response term. Other things, I think it is very simple words you can write it. So now frequency response of a non-linear system. So what do you mean by frequency response of a linear system is, linear system, you are applying a sine wave and you are measuring the output. So it is a standard system, means the gain will be 1. So if you are applying A here, it will, the gain is amplified this A only. If you are not standard system, means it will be coming A dash. The A sin omega t you are applying, you will get A dash sin omega t plus 5. So this one is magnitude maximum t, and this sin omega t here it is a phase difference. So in LTI system, if you are changing this A, this A dash will change, but the response will be remain same. Response in the sense, for a non-linear system you are applying, the clamping, clipping will happen. Sometimes distortion also will happen. In that case, LTI system, we are giving the step response, like if you are giving 1 volt or 100 volt, the response they will be same. Like that, if this system you are giving a low value input, this relationship of magnitude and phase will be same. So magnitude, so mod of m of j omega, so you are measuring only the sigma plus j omega s equal to, so if the sigma part you are not considering, only the sinusoidal transformation, the j omega part only you are considering for sinusoidal response. So the magnitude will be this to this, and phase is this phi. So you are plotting with respect to logarithm is k, log omega and m. So this scale is actually log omega, and you are applying very low frequency to a very high frequency, and how the magnitude is changing, that you are noting, that is called magnitude plot. In that magnitude plot, the magnitude is 20 log g of j omega. This 20 log you are taking because you are taking here log scale. X axis is log scale. So y axis also making it log scale, you are multiplying it by 20 log. And the magnitude we are plotting with respect to this omega. That is called magnitude plot. And phase plot also log omega with respect to phase. So these two plots you are doing for a LTA system. So LTA system, what you are doing? You are applying one sine wave of particular one frequency and taking the response and plotting this point. Again, you will change the frequency and you will get the output, and again you are plotting this phase and magnitude. So again you are applying another frequency of input and taking the output, and you are plotting like this. So MATLAB will give very low frequency to very high frequency and plot the entire dots, and it will combine and it will look like this plot. That is MATLAB doing. So each and every frequency it will supply a sine wave and take the output and giving the magnitude and phase. This is how the Bode command is working. So now your system is not a LTA system. Your system is non-linear system. So non-linear system, if you are taking a Bode plot, so it will do what it is doing for a linear system. It will take a very low frequency to very high frequency, and it will linearize the model, and it will give you a Bode response. That is magnitude and phase plot. So if you are doing a linear system, it will take amplitude as very low value, and it will do like that. If it is a non-linear system also, the amplitude will be very less if you are doing with a Bode command in MATLAB. So MATLAB is thinking that the amplitude remains constant. So your purpose, the non-linear system, you can model and you can work with limited points only. Limited points is your desired points, or your desired, what is your desired value. That is why you are choosing this motor and this controller, and your all the things are choosing for that particular area only. So nonlinear system is, this is nonlinear system, and in the party this one is linear system, and your nonlinear system you are choosing something like this only, a small area. So it should work in this area only. If it is going beyond this area, whatever you are expecting, that won't come. So your desired points you have to choose, and you have to apply correct sine wave for that particular application and take the response. If it is going beyond that one, it won't work for all your controllers. You have to change the controller for other purpose also. If you are, this area is changing to here, you have to design some other controller and some other things for this area. So if you are doing for this area, everything is limited to this area only. So if you are taking a step response, means you have to specify the step maximum value. So last time you have done that only, you are applied a 100% command amplitude corresponding to motor deflection. So here also you have to do like that only. You have to supply a value corresponding to this one only. Okay. Fine. So in this point, you have to apply a sinusoidal wave corresponding to your system frequency. So your system is working at 5 Hz band. So you have to choose very less value and very much higher value for plotting your response. So 5 Hz is coming here. You can choose up to 10, 100. The logarithm scale is 1, 10, 100, and 0.1, 0.01. So you have to apply a sine wave. Before that, you have to generate a sine wave. So generating a sine wave, you have to follow a certain command called sinusoidal sweep command. So sinusoidal sweep command, this is for clearing closure, is for clear things. If you are doing this clear all, and the workspace will be cleared. So if you want to run these things, if you are adding this clear all command, then this parameter 2 you have to run again. So I am choosing the sample time 0.001. TC and L 0 and 1 I am taking, and I am applying a first frequency, first set of frequency, that is from 0.1 to 0.9 with a step of 0.1. So you are applying 0.1, 0.2, 0.3 up to 0.9. So this many frequencies I am generating here with a step of 0.1. So low range value 0.1 to 0.9, you are applying a step of 0.1. That frequency number 2 is 1 to 9, you are taking 1, 2, 3 up to 9. So first set of frequencies 0.1, 0.2 up to 0.9, then 1 to 9. So from 10 to 100, 10, 15, 20 up to 100. So your bandwidth is 5 Hz. So you are choosing 0.1 to 100. So 1 decade below and 1 decade above. So your frequency is 5 Hz. So that you are choosing 1 decade below and 1 decade above. So this is called this section. This section is your model. Now your system frequency is working at 5 Hz, means have to choose lower range of 0.1 and higher range of 100. If you are choose system is working at 100 hertz and you are choosing 0.1 and 100, it is not enough. So you have to go for 1 decade ago, 1000 and 10, it is fine. So according to your system frequency, you have to vary this parameter. So 1 decade below, 1 decade above, it is a great choice. So that is why here you are giving a frequency of like that. So this frequency is convolution of these frequencies. So 0.1, 0.2 up to 0.9, 1 up to 9, 10 to 100. And we are applying A is 10. A is 10 means amplitude. You are giving an amplitude of 10. So you are giving amplitude of 10 means you will get a sine wave of amplitude 10. The amplitude you can change by changing the value of capital A. And T last is first is mentioned 0. And you are doing for J is equal to 1 to length of frequency, that TP you are measuring, NJ you are measuring. And frequency is less than 1. If the frequency is less than 1 means 0.1 to 0.9, you are taking one sample only. So at the steady state only you are taking the response. The Bode plot is defined as at the steady state you have to measure the values. So at low frequency you are taking one sample only. This 0.1 hertz, you are taking only one sample. The frequency is less than 10 hertz. 10 hertz means this value 1 to 10, 1 to 9 value. You are taking 3 samples. So the frequency 1 means it will take 3 samples of that one, and 2 also it will take 3 samples, 3 also it will take 3 samples, like that. Else you have to take 5 samples. So after 10 to 100, it will take 5 samples each. So particular frequency, 10 hertz frequency, 5 samples, 11 hertz frequency, 5 samples, like that. So sinusoidal response means the response is taken at the steady state only. So any doubt is there, SAMS are last week, not this Friday, last Friday lecture you have to look at. Steady state response is taking at the steady state only, that everything is valid. So steady state it has to attain. So minimum very low frequency it will attain early. So if it is one frequency at all, you have to wait for some 3 samples. Above that the frequency is increasing, the 5 samples it will be settling. So you have to choose those things. So IST you are fixing. So L2 last value, that T you are calculating, frequency you are generating, and you are generating sine wave. RC is equal to A into sine 2 pi F T. So R you are generating as 2 pi F T. A into 2 pi ft is the sine wave. So the RC you are generating and T you are increasing, and up to T last you are finding everything, and you will get capital R as a vector of this RC and this time T as another vector. That is RC is onto I elements. So T also like that. So T vector and R vector you will get. plotting t comma r means it will get the sinusoidal in amplitude curve. That is called sinusoidal shift. So you are generating a sinusoidal shift wave. Why it is shift called? It is from this point 1 to that 100 hertz. It is actually generating a sine wave, and that is plotting. So you are generating a this a amplitude sine wave of different frequencies. So these frequencies you have to apply this simulink. So here t dash r dash means transpose of those values. At a particular time you will get particular value. At a particular this particular time this particular value you will get. This time t and r, this again time t and r. So each time t and r you will get each values. That values is giving to your system. This value is given to your system, and your system is running with this t dash and r dash. That means you are supplying a sinusoidal input of variable frequencies, and you are measuring this y and t. You are measuring this y and t, and that is noted. And this noted y and t, you are doing a discrete time Fourier analysis. That program is called DTFA. This DTFA program is finding the frequency response from experimental simulation. So these values you have to load. Come parameter. This y is coming from this simulink only. This y and this t. If you are using some other variables, you have to change here. This y and t are. Whatever I mentioned here is coming from simulink only, and loading this parameter, and this TS is I am measuring this T of I comma T of 4, that is sampling time. Everything is fixed. For I is equal to length of S, the T and you are calculating number of samples. I am calculating ending point of those values, and A. Amplitude A is there, and P and Q are making zero, and phi you are measuring like this, and you are varying starting to end. K is varying from starting to end, and you are finding out the Fourier variable, that is A cos 2 pi f t terms, and A sine terms you are calculating here. And P and Q are you are modifying, and gain is equal to square root of P square plus Q square, and phase equal to tan inverse Q comma P. So the gain and phase is coming like that. So this you have to plot it in logarithm scale. That is why this square root is coming here. That is a 20 log. The magnitude only you have to take. This is square time coming. Square root is coming. That is why 10 log P square plus Q square is coming here. And this is for all quadrant. That is why 180 by pi into A tan 2. A tan 2 is taking for that purpose only. If the phase is greater than 0, you have to that subtraction 360. 0 to 360 is there. 0 and 360 are coming here. So you have to divide those points, and you have to subplot. Subplot means 2 comma 1 means 2 rows and 1 column. And first column you are plotting semi log x, f comma gain. So f comma gain you are, that is gain here and f here. So semi log x and x level frequency and y level magnitude you are plotting here. So you will get body magnitude plot here, and subplot 2, 1, 2 means it will be here, and you are measuring the phase and this frequency, and here it is phase only. So grid on means you will get the discrete time Fourier analysis waveform of the system you are measuring. Now you have to do so the frequency response of nonlinear system is a function of input command. Input command it is depending because it is a nonlinear system, and the ratio amplitude you are measuring only the fundamental, that is first frequencies only, the harmonics you are not measuring, sinusoidal command, and MATLAB program is C.M is there, and DTFA will be there. You are simulated with 0.001 only last time also. So in that configuration parameter, you have to run it with 0.001, otherwise some error might be coming. This lab, I think so much error might be coming because you have to change so many things, because last time you are done the configuration parameter should be 0.001, and you are generating a sine wave here, and that sine wave is applying there. So the simulation time you are choosing your 1 or 2, it will be giving some error because that much data is there, that much time won't be there. So your simulation time should be max of capital T. So yeah, capital stop time of simulating should be max of capital T, otherwise some error will happen. So you will get T and Y from the workspace, and you have to change these values. So you have to supply a command amplitude 2%, 5%, 10%, and 100% of this value. So this is A. Now in that program it is written A is equal to 10. That is means you will get 10 sine omega T only you will get. But if you want to command amplitude 100% means this is command amplitude, 100% command amplitude is this one only. So like that last time, the step input you are giving, the maximum 100% is 4 into 398 into 5 by 190. This one is maximum command amplitude. So 100% you want 10%, 5%, 2%. You have to measure for this one only. So you have to change that A of sinusoidal shape, and the frequency vector is like this. So number of cycles you have to choose, 1 cycle for 0.1 to 0.9, 3 cycles for 1 to 9 hertz, and 5 cycles for 10 to 100 hertz. And you have to find only the -3 dB bandwidth and -90 bandwidth for this purpose. You can measure anything, but you have to submit the reports for only -3 dB bandwidth and -90 degree bandwidth. These things only you have to submit. You can do so many things in this, whatever you are doing for body, that peak to peak value, this the MPK value also you can measure, derivative like that things you can measure. But yeah, we want only these two things. So you can do this. First you have to create the last model shape we can take, but the stop time to should be max of capital T. And another thing is this model configuration parameter, everything should be 0.001, otherwise the error will come because you are generating a sine wave of 0.001 only, sampling time of 0.001. So if you are using the sheep command first, the sheep.m first, that clear is there, clear command is there. So I am using only this clear. So clear all you are pressing, this parameter file also it will vanish. So sheep.m will create some sinusoidal function like this, 1 hertz like this, and you have to supply this to there, and this parameter file now it is not cleared because I am clearing these many values only. So if you are pressing clear all means all the parameter file will vanish. And the command amplitude you have to give this, not this one. What I mentioned here you have to supply. This is for 100%. A should be 100% this one. Like that you have to change. And first you run this seep.m, then the parameter file, then this model file. This is from workspace only. Only change is this one. This is actually from workspace. From workspace. Simin. There you can put T dash R dash capital T dash space capital R dash. It is transpose of those two values. So T dash R dash is coming there. Then you can run this model. And this T and R should be in array. If you are using time series, if you are running the DTFA command, you will get so much error. Now I am doing for one only. There is one is not at all valid. A amplitude is one only. This A amplitude is one only. What I am doing? So I am running this one with the max of capital T. So if now I am running this DTFA file, I will get frequency response for that. But that frequency response is not a valid response because I am using A as one only. Yeah, this is I am got after one is supplying to the system. But you have to supply whatever it is mentioned here. So I am getting these things. So minus 3 where it is coming. That value you have to choose, and minus 90 where it is crossing, that value you have to choose, and you have to fill these things. That much only for today's. So you can start doing now. Models remain same as last. This external disturbance is zero. T dash R dash you have to supply here. And for this purpose, this max of T can change. For D part, max of T you can change, and you can supply sine wave here. Sine. The sine wave here 100% and 10% command amplitude. 100% and 10% command amplitude of this one. 4 into 5 into 398 into 5 by 180 you have to give 100% and 10% of this value. So this much only for today's lab. So we can start doing. Any doubt is there, you can ask. Twenty-seven people only registered there. So anybody is here?
Yes, sir.